Hello again. This time I will show you how to connect the bilioambil acceptor to an Arduino board. The wiring is pretty simple. Most of it is for connecting the LCD bil acceptor, just these wires and maybe the connection from 12 volts to VIN if you want your Arduino to be powered from 12 volts. Mine is from USB. At first I wanted to show you only the hardware setup and to find some code from the internet for the bil acceptor, some sketch. There are many sketches for a coin acceptor or a bil acceptor in a pulse mode, but I couldn't find any at least close to usable and safe, even for a pulse protocol at amateur level. Most lack any basic security and are hardly usable. Some are using a pulse in, which locks the thread waiting for the pulse to complete. Some are reading the pin from time to time, requiring you to do that fast enough not to miss a pulse. And the code is pretty complicated. Some are using pin change interrupt leading to uncontrollable results in case of fast parasitic pulses or jammers. For them you need a hardware debouncing. So I made a better one myself using a timer 1 interrupt and the timer 1 library. The timer interrupt is triggered at any 1 millisecond. There in the handler the pin is read by a routine, then the pulses are counted in background. A better security is added by filtering the pulses by length, as recommended by the bil acceptor manufacturers when using pulse protocol. Else you can do anything you want in your loop, in your setup section of the sketch. You can use delay, long loops, anything you wish, except for disable interrupts for a long time, which breaks also the MIDIs and different other functionalities of the Arduino board. You have there in the code two macros, bil acceptor enable and bil acceptor disable, which use the enable pin of the bil acceptor, and a function that reads the pulses counter. This is made thread safe, so you won't be in the middle of reading the pulse value while the interrupt changes it. And also a function clear pulses with which clears the pulse counter. There are two defines at the beginning of the program, pulse width and pulse delta. The pulse width in milliseconds and the acceptable pulse width error percentage. So let's see how it works. Insert 10 ROM. Again, as any bil acceptor, that uses pulses, the bill acceptor will lock until the pulse are counted. You see? Then now is ready to receive the next bill. Again, Tendron. You see the acceptor is locked. Now it can receive the next bill. Excellent. Let's see what happens if someone uses a jammer. Basically, the jammers are shorting the pulse output to ground, simulating some pulses from the bill acceptor. I did the same myself. Here is the pulse output and this is the ground. You see, nothing happens. See? So, let's see how it works without the security, as other bill acceptor, other sketches do, just counting the pulses without any filtering. I will put the pulse error to 50%. And upload the sketch to the Arduino board. Of course, the code still works the same way, but what happens is that if I short the pulse input to ground, you see many pulses. Very easy to insert fake bills. You see, again with 2% error, I change to see again how it works the filtering. And let's see, nothing. It is possible, but you have to be very to have patience. Nothing. So that's all for today. Thank you for watching our video. We are waiting you for other interesting videos. Please come back. Go to our blog webpage where you can find many interesting articles. And to our company page, see below the video, where you can buy the bill acceptor. Please contact us, we can help you with anything you want, counseling and everything. Bye bye.